Welcome back, dear friends. Today we are going to discuss one more experiment which is based on forced vibration. So the aim of experiment is to determine the frequency response curve under the different damping conditions for single degree of freedom system at transverse vibration. Apparatus required for that is piston, cylinder, which is commonly called as damper, with oil seal, and then vibrating beam and motor with unbalanced mass. So there are certain conditions which we are going to discuss. Four conditions are there: all hole open, all hole closed, one hole open, two hole open, and all hole open. So let us have a look at our what you can say setup first of all, so that you will get familiar with the apparatus. So dear friend, this is universal vibration apparatus in which we have performed so many experiments. As you are aware about the universal vibration apparatus, this is for two rotor system which we have performed over here in order to find out the node point. This is for frequency determination of single rotor system for transverse vibration, which we have completed earlier. And now we are looking forward for force vibration apparatus. So this is force vibration apparatus. You can see there is a rotor. This is unbalanced mass, which we call it as eccentricity, and this is a motor. Okay, so continuous excitation is given through this motor, and this unbalanced mass gives us external excitation. This is a vibrating beam. You can see over here, this is a whole vibrating beam suspended with a spring system over here. There is a stylus recorder and a chart, strip chart over here, which will note down the vibration amplitude of vibration. And you can see the most important arrangement over here is as this exciting force is vibrating the whole beam. So we are able to measure the RPM with the help of this RPM sensor. This is RPM sensor over here. I'm making you familiar with the apparatus. And this is your damper over here. You can see how the arrangement in damper is. This is your piston, and same arrangement is inside the cylinder also. And you can see three holes over here. Here there are three holes, 1, 2, 3. Right now all three holes are open, and I will let you know how to close all the holes little by little. This is one hole closed. Okay, this is one hole closed, this is two hole closed, this is three hole closed, means all hole closed. Okay, so as we are closing down the holes, we are increasing the resistance, and as we are opening the holes, we are minimizing the resistance, and actually resistance to vibration is damping. And inside this cylinder there is oil, and this is oil seal of the cylinder, and this cylinder will be reciprocating. As this mass gets rotated, the beam gets excited, and due to vibration it vibrates, and due to vibration it jumps up and fall down. And you can see it jumps up and fall down on regular basis. And this stylus equipment which is here is there to measure the amplitude of vibration. Okay, so here RPM will be get noted over here. This is RPM sensor, and with the help of this rheostat we can actually vary the speed of the rotation of this motor. Okay, so this is all about the apparatus. And if any difficulties you face regarding equipment, you please do comment in your video, and I'll definitely come up to you. And this is our demostat, and this is for RPM sensor, and this is this button. If we on this button, then it will start the strip chart. Strip chart is mentioned over there. Okay, so it the strip which is there, it will progress, and vibrating pain will
mark the amplitude over here likewise. Okay, so this is all about our universal vibration apparatus setup containing force vibration apparatus. So this is for your understanding and what you can say, this is for your knowledge. Okay, so this is all about your apparatus. Thanks for watching. So as per our first condition, all hole closed. So I will have to close down every hole. This is first hole closed, this is second hole closed, and this is third hole closed. Okay, so piston is on the condition of all hole closed, and now we can actually get started with the equipment. I'm little by little enlarging the RPM, increasing the RPM of the machine, and you can see this is stylus recorder, and this stylus recorder is right now is right now having hardly any kind of deviation in between. Okay, this is stylus recorder. We need to adjust it as per our condition of pain, and then this graph is going to get rotated. So this is all hole closed condition right now. Hardly be there any kind of variation in speed. Okay, so stylus recorder is now recording. Since the speed is low, there is hardly be any kind of deviation, any kind of vibration is there also, and now we are increasing the vibration. So as the vibrations are increasing, deviation is also increasing. Now you can note down the RPM where it starts recording the deviation. Now there will be significant increase in deviation again. As the speed increases, you can see the amplitude increases. Okay, now again I am increasing the speed, again amplitude is increasing. So now, dear friends, looking at the strip chart, when RPM is near about zero, there were hardly kind of any kind of deviation, hardly be any kind of amplitude increase. But as we increase the RPM, the deviation gets started. You can see over here, deviation gets started. So it is increase in X value, means increase in deviation. So again, by increasing speed, again increasing in deviation is there. Then further increase in speed, further increase in deviation. But after a certain amount of time, there is decrease in deviation over here. As compared to this amplitude is lesser. You can see over here. So here there is drop in deviation, or what you can say, steady state amplitude. Here there is decrease in steady state amplitude. So this is the proof of the this graph is exactly the proof of our experiment, where you can see the bell shape curve over here. Means here there is starting from zero to the peak value and again diverting to the zero value. So this is the bell shape curve you can see over here, and this is the only thing which we are able to observe through this experiment. We are here to understand the concept of bell shape curve and how it is influencing the experiment of force vibration is only our matter of study. So dear friends, as the graph we are going to get plot on your x and y axis,
we are able to plot here on y-axis the displacement, or you can see the amplitude of steady state amplitude we can plot over y-axis. This is the output of your stylus equipment, so we will be putting it on y-axis, and input is speed. We are increasing the speed, so input is speed, and we are plotting speed over the x-axis. And here with increasing speed you can see there is a significant rise in the steady state amplitude, and then there is significant slowdown in the steady state amplitude. Right from the beginning there is a slowdown in steady state amplitude, then sudden rise is there, and then again there is slowdown in steady state amplitude. So this this phenomenon we are going to observe in this experiment. This is the important phenomenon, and this is the bell shaped curve which we are going to plot out of it. And after measurement of your amplitude, you will be able to plot this bell shaped curve. How to measure x? X value we can find it out with the help of this formula. X is equal to x zero divided by under root of 1 minus omega by omega n square whole square plus 2 zeta omega by omega n whole square. So this is the formula for it, and we hardly be focusing on the formula just because we don't here we don't able to get analytical method analytical solution of this, and we are not focusing on the analytical method, but here through practical performance we are going to find out these values. So if this x is the steady state amplitude and this is the amplitude due to external excitation force, then if x is the overall steady state amplitude and x0 is the amplitude due to external excitation force, then x is equal to f0 by k. So this is the formula for it. This is theoretical calculation formula, and we are going to plot a table over here in which first column will be of serial number, then steady state amplitude x value we are going to plot over here, then speed in rpm we are going to plot over here, then we are going to find the angular speed over here which is in terms of 2 pi n by 60, and in terms of radians per second, and then frequency finally fn, which is, as we know that fn is equal to 1 by 2 pi into omega. So this is the table which we are going to gain out of it, but ultimately through graph we are able to focus upon the concept of this experiment. We are here to understand about how the effect of increase in angular speed affects the steady state amplitude or displacement of the stylus equipment. Okay, so as the angular speed increases, the steady state amplitude rises from zero level, it reaches its peak value, and then it slow down again. Again, if you consider all these four steps over here, if you consider all these four steps over here, first is all hole closed. So this was the condition where all hole were closed. Then one hole open. This is the case where one hole open. Then two holes open. Then this is the case where two holes open and all hole open, and this is the case where all hole were open. So as you can see that the steady state amplitude, the level of steady state amplitude increases as the resistance to the vibration decreases. Okay, resistance to the vibration decreases means three holes open. All holes open means three holes open over here. So resistance is minimum over here. So amplitude level increases. Then for the next condition, when two holes were open, the amplitude is little bit diminished as compared to the earlier case. Then in case of one hole open, it is lesser than the earlier value. The bell shaped curve, you can see the intensity of bell shaped curve, it is lesser than the earlier value. Then when the case of all hole closed is considered, then you can see there is minimum deviation in case of amplitude, steady state amplitude is considered. So this is the phenomenon which we are going to observe through this experiment. Okay, so this is all about the concept of experiment. Let us have a look at value wise analysis of the experiment.
So dear friends, you can see over here on y-axis there is a steady state amplitude. Over here we can see in x terms, and this is angular speed. As we increase the angular speed from zero to maximum, you can see in every case there is a formation of bell shape. In every case there is a formation of bell shape curve. Okay, so this is for three holes open. This condition is for three holes open. So it there is a significant rise from earlier level to next level and up to the peak, and after the peak there is significant fall down in the angular as the angular speed increases, there is significant fall down in the displacement or angular what you can say steady state amplitude. Okay, so here the case of three holes open case, and then when we marches upon the second hole, two holes open case, then again you can see the same condition, same bell shape curve occurring over here, but this curve is formed little bit at the lower level of the earlier case, just because as the what you can say resistance to the vibration increases, the amplitude decreases. So this is the case where resistance to the amplitude increases, vibration decreases. Again for the next case, resistance increases just because one hole is open, so resistance increases, and again the amplitude decreases over here. And lastly, when all holes were closed, the high resistance you will observe over here, and decrease in the amplitude you can find over here. So this is all about the all four conditions which we have seen. So let us have a look at our chart values when all hole were closed. So it is plot of all hole closed condition. So for first case you can see RPM 460 and x value is 0.5 millimeter. By dividing this whole value through a middle line, we can actually measure the amplitude which is above the mean value of the line. Okay, so this is your for starting condition. Then this is reading number 2 at 710 RPM. You can see x value is 1 mm. So this is the next level. Then next level to this is n value, means RPM is about 1035 RPM and x value is about 1.5 millimeter. So this is next level. Again it is increasing trend. You can see it is increasing trend, and it increases up to this level. Okay, increases up to this level, that is the RPM about of 1550 RPM with x value as 9 millimeter. Okay, but right after this trend there is decrease in trend. You can see over here in very sixth position there is decrease in trend. You can see the amplitude levels are not as high as this earlier case. So here at 2268 RPM the x value is about 4.5 millimeter, whereas in earlier case x value was 9 millimeter. So it is near about half of it, and this is the trend where decreasing of the amplitude gets started. Okay, so this is the case. So this is all the case to understand the trend value. Okay, so likewise you can see in the plot of one hole open condition, now you can actually read the hole values. You can actually read the condition of hole value. Just look at the increasing trend. Increasing trend is, this is with x value 1 millimeter, this is 1.25 millimeter, this is 1.5 millimeter. So trend is increasing, and up to x value up to 11 millimeter it is increasing trend. Okay, and right after that the trend is decreasing. You can see over here with x value as 5 millimeter. So same trend you are observing in one hole open condition. Now you can see two hole open condition. In two hole open condition, again you can see there is increasing trend. There is increasing trend up to this value, means where RPM is up to 1560 RPM and X is equal to 6 mm. So this is increasing trend, and now you can see the trend is decreasing in the very next level. At RPM level is 2230 RPM and X value is about 5 mm. So it is lesser than earlier case, you can see. So trend is decreasing means it is the fall down side of the bell shape curve. Okay, so right after that you can see the third condition where three holes were open. Again there is increasing trend. Again there is increasing trend up to this condition where RPM is about 1550 RPM and X value, means steady state amplitude, is about 10 mm. So right after that the trend is decreasing. Okay, this is the decreasing trend over here, and here the X value is about 6 mm. So N is equal to 2230 RPM and at this level you can see the decreasing trend. Okay, so this is all about the experiment. You can actually understand the significance of the experiment. The significant experiment is that you can actually study the curve. You can actually study the curve, and you can actually understand out of this curve that the same trend is get followed whatsoever may be the condition of damping. But as the resistance to damping, increases or decreases in that condition, it is a vice versa condition for the steady state amplitude. If the damping increases, the amplitude decreases, and if the damping decreases, the amplitude increases. Okay, so you can understand out of it. So this is all about the conclusion of the topic. Thanks for watching. Now let us look at the tabulated form of the plotted values. First is for serial number, second is for steady state amplitude of the vibration. So steady state amplitude you can measure over here by drawing a middle line to the obtained charted graph. Means middle line means, so let us have a look at how to find this X value. So here the graph which we obtained is divided through this mean line, and right after that the uppermost part is the amplitude of it, and this X value we can actually judge out of it. So this value we have to measure with the help of scale and write down over here. Okay, so this is here there is 6 mm, you can see. So you can actually have idea about it. Okay, right after that you have to measure the RPM, and then with the help of finding RPM you can actually find twice pi n by 60, that is your omega value. And right after that you can find the frequency by this formula, omega by 2 pi. Okay, so this is the case we have to repeat in every of the situation, means one hole open, two hole open, and all hole open condition. Okay, so this is all about the today's experiment. So this is how we need to plot the our values and plot our graph and find out the conclusion. So ultimately coming up to the conclusion of the today's experiment, so ultimately we are able to observe the bell shape curve every time of the experiment, and with rise and fall with the damping values, the bell shape curve alters its position. So whatsoever the position we have seen, that position we can plot over the graph and can have conclusion about the graph. So thanks for watching. Thank you so much.